Now at the sign of the bell on the road to Clonmel, Paddy Hegarty kept an itchy bean. He sold pig's meat and bread, kept a fine lodging bed, and was liked in the country he lived in. Now himself and the wife, they both struggled through life. On weekdays, Pat mended the ditches. Ah, but on Sundays, he dressed in a suit of the best. His pride was his old leather breeches. Last winter, the snow kept provisions so low that poor Paddy was ate out completely. With the snow coming down, he could not get to town. Thoughts of hunger did bother him greatly. One night as he lay a-dreaming away of ghosts and spirits and witches, now he heard an uproar just outside of the door, so he jumped up and pulled on his breeches. Well, says Brian McGurk with the voice like a Turk, ah, come Paddy and get us some eating. And says Big Andy Moore, we'll burst open the door, now this is no night to be waiting. Well, the words were scarce spoke when the door it was broken. They crowded round Paddy like leeches, and they swore by the hob if they didn't get grub, sure they'd ate him clean out of his breeches. Well, poor Paddy, in dread, he slipped up to the bed that held Judy, his own darling wife, in. And there 'twas agreed that they needed a feed, so he went out and brought a big knife in. Well, he cut out the waist of his breeches, the best, and he ripped out the buttons and stitches, and he did them in stripes, you know the way they do tripes, and he boiled them his own leather breeches. Well, as they dined on the stuff, now says Darby, that's tough, says Andy, you're no judge of mutton. Ah, when Brian McGurk on the pint of a fork, he held up a big ivory button. Now says Paddy, what's that? Sure, I thought it was fat. Brian leaps to his feet and he screeches, be the powers above, I was trying to shove me teeth through the seat of his breeches. Well, they all flew at Pat, but he got out of that, for he ran when he saw them all rising. And says Brian, make haste and go for the priest, be the holy Saint Patrick, I'm poisoned. Now revenge for the joke they had, for they broke all the chairs, bowls and tables and dishes. And from that very night they'd knock out your daylight if they'd catch you without leather breeches.